A principal finding is that the traditional estimate of 620,000 male deaths in the American Civil War is about 20% too low. We've underestimated the destructiveness of the war and its demographic, economic, and social impact. We should remember that this 750,000 deaths occurs when the population is about 31, 32 million. Today's population, we're about 10 times the size, about 310 million people living in the United States today. If the war had that same impact on today's population, we'd be talking about 7.5 million deaths in a war, just to give you some sense of the scale of this war and its impact on society. So this is the excess proportion of men dying in the 1860s. If we look at the age group 15 to 19, about 12 to 14% of men in that age group die above what would be expected in the 1860s. And this excess mortality rate falls by age, and that's a result of participation rates in the war itself, you know. Certainly the new figure suggests the war is much more destructive in terms of the cost of human life than it was with the traditional estimate. But we should remember that these death totals are a result of Union armies facing Confederate armies. And in no other American war do we count enemy deaths with our own deaths in a measure of its cost. So in some ways, the war is much more destructive than we think it is. In other ways, we have to remember that more than two out of three deaths were a result of disease. So we're looking at something just over 200,000 to 300,000 battle deaths, and consider that those are from two different armies. So in some ways, yes, this is the most destructive, bloodiest war in American history, but we have to be careful how we use those figures.